Pavan and Sonia are siblings. Pavan is only a year younger than Sonia, but is very naughty and curious. The kids and their father love to travel a lot. The whole family visits a new place every year during the summer holidays. One day, both the kids were bathing in a nearby stream. Father was also on leave that day and he was also enjoying with them.
Pavan, let's see who can hold breath longer underwater.
Okay, Sonia.
Both dives underwater. Pavan holds his breath only for a short time. Sonia holds her breath for a little more time.
You lost. I held my breath for longer time.
Leave it. You were also unable to hold your breath for long time.
So what? We are not dolphins who can hold their breath for a long time underwater.
Sonia, think about it. The fishes and aquatic animals who live underwater are so different from us.
Rightly said. Fishes have streamlined body shape which helps them to swim underwater. The tail of aquatic animals and the scales of fish also help them move. Children, do you know how do dolphins breathe? And how is it different than the breathing of fish?
Dolphins breathe through the hole on their head by coming to the surface of the ocean. They expel water from these holes and take the fresh air in.
Yes, and the fish breathe through their gills. When the fishermen take the fish out of the water, they start wriggling, and if they do not leave them in water again, they die within minutes.
Rightly said. Do you remember when we went to Goa? We saw various types of fishes there.
Yeah, we do remember a bit about that. But traveling reminds me of Rajasthan, where we had a lot of fun while riding the camel.
Kids, I have also taken beautiful pictures of your camel ride.
Father, it has been a while. I want to see those pictures again. Why don't we go home and check our family album?
Yay! I also want to see those pictures.
Kids got very excited to see the family album and moved towards home all together. On reaching home, they take out the family album and start seeing their pictures.
Look, here is the picture of our camel ride. The uncle who owned the camel had told us that camel is also called the ship of the desert as it can travel for hours in the hot and sandy deserts.
Yes, and he also told us that the hump of the camel contains fat which helps them survive for a long time without food. Camels do not sweat and they release a small amount of water during urination.
It is amazing that whenever a camel gets water, they can drink more than 100 liters of water in a go.
That is why they can live for days without water in such a hot climate. Pavan, do you know that camels are found not only in Rajasthan, but also in the cold deserts of Ladakh? And what's funny is that the species of camels found in the hilly areas of Ladakh have two humps.
Really? But when we went to Ladakh, we could not see any camels there.
But look, we had a great time with yaks there.
Of course, yak riding was also so much fun.
Not just the ride, the milk of yak was also very delicious, right?
Didi, does the hair of yak makes it favorable to the cold climate of Ladakh?
Yes, I have read in a book that all the animals adapt to their environment and habitat. If I remember correctly, it is called adaptation.
You have rightly said, I was so much astonished on seeing the mountain goats. Do you remember how they climbed the rugged and steep slopes of mountains so fast with the help of their hooves?
Yes, I was also surprised. It felt amazing to watch them climbing.
Although the ability of animals to adapt itself according to the environment is very surprising. Once I read in an interesting book that a frog, namely wood frog, is found in the extremely cold areas of America and Canada. It completely freezes during the winters. Then a thick layer of snow covers these regions. Even the heartbeat of this frog pauses for months, and it feels like that the frog is dead. But when summer arrives, suddenly it comes back to life.
Really? That's amazing. I knew that many animals like bears sleep during the whole winters. This process is known as hibernation. For this, they eat a lot during summer to store fat in their body for winters. But this frog is ahead of all of them.
Children, if we see, not only the animals which can move, but the plants also adapt as per their environment. Like the leaves of trees of rainforests are huge, so that a lot of transpiration can take place from their surface. It is because there is excess water in rainforests.
And the plants of deserts?
The leaves of desert plants are either very small or they turn into thorns in order to reduce transpiration from their surface. The roots of these plants also go deep into the soil so that they can soak up water as much as they can, because there is water scarcity in the deserts.
Papa, after seeing all these pictures, I feel like traveling again to some amazing place. Where are we going in the next vacations?
You kids think about it and tell me when you decide. Now it's time to cook. I'm going to cook something delicious.
Papa, I will help you. Pavan, till then you decide where should we go in the next vacations.
Yesterday evening, Sonia and her younger brother Pavan were discussing about living beings and their ability of adaptation. Today, when they were playing, many questions crossed Sonia's mind. She thought that why don't continue the discussion with Pavan and their mother?
Mother, yesterday, Pavan and I were discussing about the adaptive capability of animals according to the environment. Regarding this, we discussed a lot about plants and animals, but I have a question in my mind. Plants are stationary, but the animals move here to there. Similarly, many non-living objects stay affixed at a place, but others are not, like air and water.
Yes, you are right. But what is your question, Sonia?
I am thinking that which are those things which differentiate living things from non-living things?
It is an interesting question. Some things are easier to comprehend. For example, how living organisms grow. We are so small at the time of birth and gradually grow and become adults. Animals like birds and reptiles lay eggs, from which their babies come out. Then they grow and become adults.
But mother, all these signs are shown by plants as well. I can understand one thing, that all living organisms consume food, from which they get nutrients and energy.
Yes, children, it proves that even plants are living beings. And in fact, plants are the primary sources of food, as they make their own food through the process of photosynthesis. Other animals depend on them for their food, either directly or indirectly.
Sonia, one more thing. The organisms consume food out of which a part of food which is unused by the body is excreted by them in the form of urine and stool. All the organisms do this.
What? But I have never seen plants excreting urine or stool.
Trees and plants excrete their waste material in a different manner. Their waste materials get accumulated in some of their parts, like leaves and bark. When too much waste gets accumulated, the trees shed their leaves and barks.
Oh! It means that all the animals consume food and excrete.
Sonia, yesterday were we not trying to hold our breath underwater? All living beings breathe too, and that too in different ways.
Yes, we learned that the terrestrial animals breathe through the nostrils, whereas fishes breathe through gills, and dolphins breathe through a hole on their head. Some other animals breathe through their skin as well, like earthworms.
And some animals, like frogs, can breathe both in water and on land. In water, they breathe through their skin, and on land, they breathe through their nostrils.
Yes, and isn't it interesting that plants breathe differently in days and nights? During the day, through the process of photosynthesis, oxygen is generated. They use the oxygen according to their need and release the rest in the atmosphere. On the other hand, after sunset, plants are unable to perform photosynthesis and start taking oxygen in and release carbon dioxide.
All this is so amazing, right? There are so many unbelievable animals in this world, possessing variations among them.
Yes, you are right. But along with these variations, they share many similarities as well. Like, animals can adapt as per their habitat. They respire, consume food, and excrete. Some animals walk and jump as per their will. And there is one more task performed by all living beings.
What is that?
That is reproduction. It is the process through which animals multiply. Some organisms lay eggs and some give birth to their young ones.
Yes, even plants reproduce through seeds. Even the roots and stems of some plants have the capability to reproduce. It is just that the plants can't move.
Movement is one of the many characteristics possessed by living beings. But movement only doesn't justify their liveliness. Other abilities like breathing, reproduction should also be present to qualify as a living being.
For example, my remote controlled car. That is why air and water are still classified as non-living, even when they can move. What a way of explaining. Thanks, mummy.
Really, there is so much variation in the world. We have discussed about only a few animals. In forests, water bodies, deserts, and grasslands, there are so many animals about which we don't even know. And there are so many microorganisms that live in our surrounding air, soil, the food we eat, and even within ourselves in our body.
Yes, and the qualities we have discussed now taught us about how living beings are different from non-living beings.
This is so interesting. In the coming summer vacation, we should visit somewhere where we can observe a lot of amazing animals.
That is why I have thought that we should visit rainforests of Kerala this summer vacation.
Yay! This is great idea. Since yesterday, I was also thinking about the same, that where should we visit. I like this plan too. We will find many amazing animals in the rainforest.
Wow! We are going to enjoy a lot then. We will definitely go to Kerala.